Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to use conditional highlighting in numbers to highlight an entire row based on the value of only one cell. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So typically, you can't use conditional highlighting on another cell. So for instance, if I want the first cell here, A2, to highlight when the value in B2 is greater than 10, I can't do it. Conditional highlighting works by adding a rule that acts based on a test of the current cell. So I can say, is this cell equal to something or greater than something or less than something? If so, change the highlighting for this cell, not for another cell. However, there is a way around that. For instance, if I want cell A2 to highlight if B2 is greater than 10, I can do it if I use a third cell as kind of a proxy. Let me show you. In this third cell here, I'm going to put a formula and I'm going to say if, and then test the cell I want to test. So this one here, and do the test. So if it's greater than 10, then the value of this cell will be the value of the cell that I want to highlight. Otherwise, it'll be something else, something that that cell could never be. So maybe we just put a single X in there, for instance, as long as I'm sure that an X would never be the value of this cell. So now you could see here, because this is greater than 10, the value of mark is in there because that's the value in A2. If I change this to 9, you could see it's an X. Okay, so how can I use this for conditional highlighting? Well, I can go to this cell, the one I want to highlight, set conditional highlighting, add a rule, and say under text, the value of this cell is, and then click here to use a value from another cell. I'll select this one and I'll hit the check mark. And then I'll say, okay, I'm going to set the highlighting to, say, a red fill. All right, so now if the value of this is less than 10, then this cell is not highlighted. If it's greater than 10, it is highlighted. I can then hide this proxy cell by going to this column here and saying simply hide the column. And now it's invisible. So how can we apply this to entire rows? Let's say we want to have all of the cells in a row highlighted if the word member is in this column. We can do the same kind of thing. So we're going to create three different proxy cells. We don't need one for the cell we're actually testing. So I'm going to stretch this out and create three extra ones here. And I'm going to put similar formulas in here. So I'm going to do if the value of this cell is equal to member, then put the value of this cell in there. Otherwise, put something that would never normally be there. So this works, and we can make it so we can easily copy and paste this. First thing we want to do is make sure that this D2 here, it stays in this column. So we will preserve the column for it. So it's always looking at column D. And then I will copy this and I will paste it throughout this. And you could see here that in the rows where the word member is here, everything matches. These three match these three. But the one row doesn't have member in it, I just get X's in it now. Now let's do conditional highlighting. I'm going to select just one cell here. And I'm going to go to cell conditional highlighting. And I'm going to add a rule saying if the text is, and click here and say that it's equal to this one, then I'm going to make it a red fill. And now I'm going to select all of the cells, the ones that will be visible. And I'm going to go to show highlighting rules and hit combine rules. And when I do so, you're going to see that it basically applies that same rule across all those cells. And everything will match up. So if I selected this one, for instance, you can see it's referring to cell G5. This one is referring to cell F3. It puts everything relative. So I get those highlighted. The last thing I want to do is I want to highlight these. So I want to select just one cell here, say add rule, and just go to that original rule that I'm using in that if statement there. So this one's going to be a little different. I'm going to make it red fill if the text is member. And then I'm going to select all of these cells, show highlighting rules, and say combine rules. So now I get the entire row highlighted. All I need to do is remember to select these rows here and then hide selected columns. Now it all seems to work like magic. If I were to remove member from there. You can see that row is not highlighted. Add it here. Then you could see it is highlighted. What if you wanted to have more than one possible highlighting? Like for instance, you wanted to be able to highlight red if they're a member, and maybe something else like provisional member, then it's blue. So what I've done here is I've created three new columns here, and they have the same formula in it basically. It's just testing for provisional instead of member, and it's putting the same value in there. So now we can go and change the highlighting for these cells. So I can select this first cell here and change the highlighting rules, add a rule, and if text is, and then select the first cell here in this new set of three proxy cells, and then make that blue fill and done. And then I could select all of these and show highlighting rules and combine the rules. So now if I were to change member to provisional, you could see the X's go here. These have the actual values, and that makes these blue. I can do the same thing I was doing before with these. I can just add a new highlighting rule here. Add a rule if text is and provisional, and change those to blue as well. So now you get a complete row there changed. I just need to go and hide these cells here. And now you can see it's blue if provisional, red if member, and blank otherwise. And the cool thing is, of course, if I add new rows, all those hidden cells get copied as well. So I can go to a new row here. I can just add a name. And then I could put member here. And you can see it makes it red, provisional, and it's blue. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.